Hey, everybody, welcome back to episode 5 of Charmed. Last time we had three stories for the three sisters. The main story revolved around Piper and Mark. Mark, unfortunately, he's a ghost, and Piper needed to help him, you know? Help him escape from Yama, the god of death who was going to bring him to hell. No, Mark, no. And it was a very sweet story because those two just worked off each other perfectly. Great chemistry. And the other story, all the stories were kind of woven in together. Phoebe got a job. She got a job because she wanted to get Prue something nice for her birthday. And her story was just comedy from start to finish. You know, she wasn't pretending to be psychic. She was actually doing her job and telling the truth. Except people don't want to hear the truth. You know? They just want people to lie to them. Even when people are coming to run them down in cars. And Prue had a surprise birthday party. Except she knew about the surprise birthday party, but she didn't really know about it, but she did. It was a good party. At the end, she got gifts and everything. So, we'll see if this episode has three stories, or if we're going to have one big combined story. We can combine our powers and obliterate somebody. Ooh, I love when they obliterate people. So, yeah, let's just get into it. Leave a comment about this episode, what you thought about it. I'll let you know what I think about it when I'm finished watching. And yeah, we'll have more fun with the show.
Are your parents terrorists? Because baby, you're the bomb.
Oh, dude.
I know an angel when I see one.
I'm no angel. I'm a witch.
Shh. Phoebe, jeez.
Oh, I'm so glad you guys are still here.
Well, they're right there.
What are you staring at?
They have been going at it for almost an hour.
Ooh. Do we know them?
No, I hate being single.
Waitress coming through.
Special delivery.
Hey, Sky.
Hi.
Sky.
I didn't order this.
I know, you have a secret admirer. Apparently, he's been eyeing Prue all night.
Ooh.
Tell him thank you, and I'm very flattered, but kind of seeing someone else? Sure.
Yeah, Andy. Andy, dude. She said no, dude.
She's flattered. She's just seeing someone else.
Sure she is. How about you?
I'm not allowed to date the customers.
Is that a rule?
I've got to run.
Interesting. We're going to see this guy again? We're going to see Sky again? Oh, he's going to be right here. Shit, I wasn't expecting it so soon, dude. No, dude, it's her bedroom. What are you doing, dude? I'm going to roll in with the wheelchair and then get out and start slashing. Okay.
Hello, Sky.
What the?
You're in my world now. You're beautiful in that dress.
Where the hell are we? Mr. Sandman?
It's your dream, but it's my fantasy. I can alter your dreams. And I can kill you. In your dream.
If I die in a dream, do I die in real life?
Did you know that if you die in your dreams,
no.
You die in real life?
Please don't hurt me!
Dude, creepapalooza.
You rejected me, and now you gotta pay.
You gonna try this with Prue?
Sweet dreams.
Wake up, Sky! Huh? Oh, the guy getting hit by the car. Hey, we're coming back the way this time.
Her name is Sky Russell, early 20s.
She did die.
Every bone in her body's been crushed.
Holy shit.
It's as if she had fallen off a 20-story building.
Yeah.
But we're inside an apartment on the ground floor.
Ground floor?
And her body hasn't been moved.
Keep going. And press.
and pray.
Ugh, I give up. 2 weeks and nothing strengthened but my temper.
That woman, of course men want her. Men are no different from women. We all want what we can't have, which is why we need to stop thinking about
Prunos.
And start thinking about what we want in a man.
Tons of fun, lots of heat, no strings attached. That's what I want.
See, but I want romance. I love love. I'd take what Prue has in a flat second.
But then you would have to deal with the family secret.
Yeah, are we allowed to tell anybody? How many people are we going to let in? Just the people we love?
Did you see the coroner's report?
What are we telling Andy?
Died of massive internal hemorrhaging.
This guy wouldn't believe us if we told him.
Maybe her body was moved.
From where? How? Front door was locked and bolted.
Yeah, he didn't actually get in. He just kind of psychically linked to her from outside.
I mean, sure not death by natural causes, which leaves only one thing.
Supernatural murder, dude.
Murder.
I wonder if this guy's going to be, like, here all the time.
Thanks.
Bon appetit.
Sky didn't show up for a shift today, so we're shorthanded.
Ooh. They don't know about Sky yet.
I found a spell. How to attract a lover.
Don't do it, Phoebe. That's gonna backfire.
No personal gain, remember?
It's against the rules.
Look, I'm not talking about marriage here. We have our 30s to freak out about that. This spell is about having a good time.
The Book of Shadows says we could reverse the spell at any time.
Oh, great. Nothing can go wrong. Weren't people literally throwing themselves at Phoebe in the previous episodes?
I was wrong. The spell calls for cayenne pepper, not black pepper.
Did I say spell?
I meant recipe. Recipe.
I meant recipe. We are so busted, aren't we?
I would say yes.
All I want is someone special in my life, and this spell provides that exactly.
And not a ghost.
You've got to be kidding.
We were hoping you would join us. You know where to find us.
See you later.
Careful what you wish for.
Yeah.
Oh,
okay, the cat.
You go first.
The
cat. You go first.
You want a man who is single, smart, endowed.
Employed.
Sorry, employed. Cuddling by a roaring fire.
Oh, she is a romantic.
Your turn.
Into the pot.
You want the sexy, silent type.
He's about hunger and lust and danger. But even though you know he'll never meet your friends or share a holiday meal with your family, you still can't stay away.
Dangerous.
It goes without saying that we both want a man who is well...
employed.
I conjure thee, I'm the queen, you're the bee.
Oh, the cat is meowing too.
As I desire, so shall it be.
What's going to happen? Are they just going to appear? Knock on the door?
You think it worked?
I don't know.
Oh!
I'm sorry, do I know you?
Oh, it's the Dreamwalker.
Sent you a glass of Chardonnay and you sent it back.
You refused me.
Look, as I told the waitress, I'm just not available.
She seems somebody.
How did you get my number? My name?
He doesn't take rejection very well.
He asked me out.
Hello?
I'm going to Quake to see if my spell worked.
I'm gonna take a bath.
Oh, bath. Don't fall asleep in the bath, Prue. That's where he gets you. Does he have to know where you live, or does he have to be close by, or can he just do it from his house? So sleepy. Yep, just a little nap. Just a little nap. Does he have to wear the gloves?
Hello, Prue.
Could she use her?
I know your every thought and desire. I'm the man of your dreams.
You are not real, you don't exist.
This is creepy.
You exist.
I can move, why can't I move?
Oh, she got woken up. Piper.
Are you okay?
Just check her back.
Yeah.
I had a really bad thing.
I'm okay now.
Don't go to sleep ever again. Find him and obliterate him.
He knew about Mom. And what about the marks on my back?
Yeah.
Piper, they were there, and now they've disappeared.
Oh, they're gone.
How many hours did you work this week?
Piper, 60, we're witches. You should believe this sort of stuff.
You don't believe me. No, I believe
You think you saw marks on your back.
Piper, you literally dated a ghost last episode?
Morning.
Oh, hello. Is this Phoebe's new guy?
Oh, I gotta run.
Okay.
I'll meet you later for lunch.
We had safe sex. A lot of safe sex. Ew.
3 young women, completely unrelated, except for the fact that they all died the exact same way as the waitress.
Oh, he likes throwing people off buildings. Maybe he lost his legs by falling or something?
I'm telling you, Piper, the spell works.
You threw his clothes all over the house. That's not a spell working, that's hormones.
She doesn't believe in magic anymore, this episode.
Mr. Manford, here you go. Chicken, rice, veggies, just
you
like it.
Thank you. And please call me Jack.
Oh, it's him.
I've got to get to know you. Have dinner with me.
Can you hang on a second?
It's all sorts of wrong, you know? Oh, he's looking at her too.
You know, you shouldn't have dinner with that guy.
No? You instead?
Why not?
You should fly to Paris with me.
Oh.
Tell her it's an emergency.
Oh, my favorite place. Oh, there she was.
Have you finished the Cromwell miniatures yet?
Rex, no, I'm still cataloging the Rembrandt sketches.
I'm glad Prue didn't do the spell, because this guy would have totally started flirting with her.
This has worked out so great, hasn't it?
Yeah.
So far. It's not real, though. It's not real, you know?
Great.
So this is a dream lab?
Yeah. I'll tell Mr. Berman that you'd like to speak with him.
Thank you. Just because Berman dated the first victim.
Julie Derrickson?
Doesn't make him a killer.
She and Berman will team together on some kind of experimental project.
Oh, here he comes. They'll be like, oh, can't be this guy. He's in a chair.
How may I help you?
We're conducting an investigation. We'd like to ask you a few questions.
Where were you last night?
Regarding? You know this woman?
Sky? Your ex-girlfriend? All these women?
She was my girlfriend. I was heartbroken when she... I still miss her.
Yeah.
Mr. Berman, could you tell us your whereabouts night before last?
I was here.
I was sleeping.
In the lab, asleep.
Any witnesses who can confirm that?
A night's worth of data, 2 scientists and a lab technician. Shall I have them paged?
Mr. Berman, is the way you're speaking, is that related to your legs? Or are you just being creepy?
When I get stressed, I get hives in very strange places.
Which
is your honesty is so refreshing.
Well, it helps keep my ulcer under control.
She's trying to turn him off. It's just, it's not working. She's. Oh, jeez, you gotta undo it.
Give me 30 cc's of Andravine.
30 cc's?
30?
That's twice the
salt. I'll be in REM sleep. Set the dream inducement system to level 12.
Hey, I'm the doctor here.
This is my grant, and give me the shot.
He's very intense.
Hello, Prue.
Shit, she fell asleep again.
Someone help!
Can't move out of the chair, can you? You're powerless, Prue.
Go to hell.
Shall I sing you a lullaby?
I don't think so.
Balls.
No!
Good night, Prue.
Oh, the phone saved her.
Ah, you're still at the office.
Tell
can
him.
I call you back?
Sure.
Thanks for calling.
I just wanted to hear your voice.
Yeah, you saved her, dude.
Okay, bye.
Yes? Bloody hell.
Just in case. Kill him. Oh, blood. Is he bleeding? Is he bleeding in real world? You know, if he dies in the dream, does he die?
The man is in a wheelchair, and he's got an alibi.
Yeah, but did you hear how creepy he sounded?
Dream leaping. Dream leaping. The ability to project himself into someone else's dreams.
It's science.
She broke up with him while they were driving, so he got into an accident.
Ah.
That's why he's paralyzed.
Let's go.
Mm-hmm. Hey, he's on board.
I'm home!
Hey, how's dating life, Phoebe? The whole house is full of flowers.
They're from men I barely know and men I've never met. It wasn't real. Love is a magic between 2 people that cannot be explained and cannot be conjured.
Even our poor cat's in hell. Go away! Ooh. Ooh.
The cat was a part of it.
Let's reverse the spell.
Hello?
Hello?
Look, I
I fell asleep and that man from my dream, he tried to kill me again. I want you to look in the Book of Shadows and he calls himself a dream sorcerer, okay?
There's gotta be something.
I'm telling you, there's no dream sorcerer stuff anywhere.
Well, maybe he's not a demon. Maybe he's immortal.
Then he's got one hell of a power.
You're not kidding.
Science.
The most important thing right now is for you to get home safely.
Don't fall asleep at the wheel.
Just keep talking. Don't let me fall asleep.
Okay, Prue, blast the air conditioning, crank the stereo, and roll down the windows. Nothing is gonna happen.
Phoebe! Piper, Phoebe.
Prue, get here, quickly.
You left me. All I could do is think about you!
Piper.
Oh, Prue's falling asleep.
Phoebe. Time is now, Prue.
Forgot she had that power.
Prue, she's not there.
No. Say goodnight, Prue.
She's not answering. What do you got? I got a 27-year-old female.
Oh, they're gonna send her to sleep with, like, a sedative or something?
Miss Hallowell, hang in there.
Stay awake.
Damn, she's unconscious.
Damn it.
Want a little wine with your death?
I don't care. We want to talk to him. Just wake him up.
Wake him up.
He's heavily sedated. Just get to work.
Do you like the dress?
I've worn better.
Oh, he loves this building, doesn't he? I do like the dream atmosphere. It's very, it looks good.
Is she okay?
Well, if you get out of the waiting room, a doctor will be right with you.
Thank you.
Let's storm in there and wake her up.
Mr. Berman, wake up! I don't care what it takes, you wake him up.
Maybe they can wake her up while she's falling? You know, in the nick of time? This guy's definitely gonna die in the dream. Prue's gonna turn the tables on him. Throw him over, Prue.
Can you hear us? Prue?
They can't help you.
You've got to fight this guy. We need you. Use your power, Prue. Use your power. You can do it, Prue.
Shall I say goodnight?
No, let me. Goodnight.
Hi, dude. Oh, oh, shit.
I don't believe it. Never doubt you again.
You'll never doubt him again? That didn't prove anything. Oh.
Knock, knock.
Yep.
Hi. Does this have anything to do with your lust spell?
Did they undo it yet?
But don't we reverse the spell last
Great.
Night?
Good.
Afternoon, ladies. Surprise.
Come on, let's go. Okay.
Glad to see every bone in your body's not broken.
The car accident. Never mind.
So, that episode was called Dream Sorcerer. Just looked it up. I think Dreamwalker would have been cooler, because he couldn't, you know, he couldn't walk in the real world, but in real life he could. You could, like, walk between people's dreams, and Dream Sorcerer works, though, too. Except it wasn't sorcery. It was science. He was in a lab. I wonder if we'll see that lab again. They have a shot of a building that looks like a science-y place. So I can imagine whenever there's experiments in the show, they'll cut to that lab. That doc will be like, oh, yeah, we've got a new experiment. We're able to turn people into super soldier demons. Just science, you know? Just what we do here at the... I don't even know what the name of the place is. So this episode, not really split into three, as the last episode was, but split into two, because Piper and Phoebe had the same story, just with different guys. There was I like that they built the characters up by showing us the kind of guys that they would be interested in, or at least they think that they want. And it's no surprise that Phoebe and Piper want completely different things when it comes to relationships. And the cat too. The cat has wishes too. Didn't have to write them down, but was there when the spell was happening and did a bit of meowing. Ooh, that cat is magical. Ooh. But the spell didn't just work on one guy, it worked on multiple guys. So even if it was working okay, the fact that there was multiple people, it was never going to work. But even if it was just one guy, Piper at least. No, actually, Phoebe didn't like the attention either. At the end, she was like, this is too much. But Piper was very, very early and very quickly trying to turn the guy off, and he was just like, oh, you know what I love about you? All your faults. They're the best part. She wants something genuine and real, and so does Phoebe. It's just that Phoebe needed a little more convincing after the fun she had. But it does build their characters. It kind of solidifies what we think we know about the two of them based on the first four episodes. It's sort of saying, yeah, what do you think these characters would want in a guy is what they would want in a guy. Prue was part of it. Prue had her own issues with a guy. And it's an interesting idea that the guy would come in through dreams, and also sort of scary because he can't sleep. And if he does have full power in there, you're screwed. But the guy... Remember Stefan from episode 2? Who, the second I saw him, the second he started speaking, I was like, this guy? This guy is evil. This guy in this episode, he was never not evil. He was never normal. You know? Just the way he would intensely speak to people. The slow sort of... I think it would have been interesting if he was just a normal, hey everybody, I'm just a... Ooh, I'm harmless, you know, just taking part in some experiments to help me walk again. Officers, is there a problem? But instead he was so intense and so kind of emotionless even. Oh, these women are dying like the way my ex died. Huh, well I was here all night, officer. The dreamscape and the music they played during the dreamscape, and the budget wasn't huge, but they made it look good. They made it look dreamy, and you kind of felt like you were in another place. Everything was slightly, it had a flow to it. I really liked that. They built the atmosphere very well. Poor Sky. Yeah. Sky got her done by. And it was Prue. She was just the messenger. He killed the messenger. You know? She went over to give the drink. Then she went back to the dude. She was like, she's seen somebody. Sorry, dude. He was like, well, what about you? And she's like, I can't. It's against the rules. Okay. I'll see you tonight. God damn it, dude. He should have waited, though, till... Like, he was still going through dream-leaping experiments. Should have waited till the experiments were done and he could do it at will, you know? Before going on a murdering rampage. Then he was undone by his own rules. If you die in the dream, you die in real life. And it's all because he got put under like 30 cc's of that stuff. He couldn't wake himself up. Thought for sure somebody was going to wake up as they were falling, you know, just before they hit the ground. So yeah, creepy episode with the guy, with the main villain. And then the humorous side with the dating. And a little more of Andy and the other guy, Norris. What's his first name? It's probably in the main titles, actually. Gotta go look at the main titles again. Cause they zoom by quickly, but wanna have them, give them a proper look now. But they just have the actors' names. Dorian Gregory. Oh, Dorian Gray, dude! He's got a picture up in his... watch for this guy. I know it's the actor's name, but... I love that we see the guy get hit by the car. Yeah. Anyway, that was episode 5. Standard villain of the week, with a bit of comedy on the side. If you like that, let me know down below. You ever met somebody like that? Who's just creepy? Just have that creepy voice all the time? No? My advice is to stay well clear of them, but don't reject them. You know, because they could have creepy dream powers. And I hope you'll come back for episode 6, where we won't have any creepy people. It'll just be just a fun episode with no magic or anything. Just, I don't know, they're all going for a picnic. So, picnic episode in episode 6, and I'll see you then.